I remember years ago I took a course. It was a funny course, too. It was called Forensic Pathology, if you can imagine. And it was taught by, if you can imagine, Sasha Shulgin. Forensic Pathology, right? So one of the things he did in this class is he brought in a little vial of some substance. And there were 500 people in this class. It was at Cal. So we passed it around. No big deal. You sniff it, a kind of a nondescript odor, pass it on to the next person. Out of the 500 people, three had an incredibly violent reaction to this stuff. And then Sasha explained, there is a known gene for reacting to this thing. People who have this gene are 50,000 times more sensitive to this substance than people without it. Well, just extrapolate that range to every substance in nature, and you will see why, in a sense, learning what drugs you should and shouldn't take is as big a task as deciding what kind of person you should or shouldn't go to bed with, what kind of investments you should or shouldn't make. In other words, it's a lifetime task of mistake-making, learning, self-observation, and correction. And what's sauce for the goose may not be sauce for the gander. And you have to honor your individuality. The shamans say, you know, if the plant wants you, it will take you. You will know if there is a lock and key fit. There is a great deal to be learned from emulating plants, especially in the culture of crisis that we're in. First of all, plants, they have to deal with their toxic byproducts because they can't move away from them the way we do and move into new niches. Plants are homeostatically self-regulating. Plants are small solar factories, essentially. Plants do all their work at temperatures below 115 degrees. Notice that we do our technologies operate at 600 degrees and up, and then produce all kinds of heavy metal toxins and poisons and this sort of thing. Also, in a sense, the Tao-like passivity of plants, the way in which they accept their circumstances. Essentially, an animal is an organism that can move away from the circumstances of its own being. And so, for all of these reasons, plants seem like an excellent model for the kind of future that we should be building. We want to go to lower energy. We want to go to more organic starting and ending materials in industrial processes. We want to create a kind of integrated homeostatic cohesion in our societies. In all these cases, and a solar-based society, in all these cases, the plants provide the model. They've been showing how to do these things very efficiently for a very long time.